In our earlier sessions on revelation and faith, we prepared the grounds for an understanding of the workings of theology, how we carry out the task of theology. A very much quoted definition of theology is faith seeking understanding. That's from St. Anselm in the 12th century. Faith seeking understanding. If you think about it, we're all theologians. We're all seeking to understand our faith. So you've got informal theology that all Christians are involved in as they reflect on their faith and interpret it for themselves. And then you've got a more formal theology. That's what we're going to discuss in this session. Now note that theology is a work of faith. Faith seeking understanding. All the great theologians who left their mark on the life of the church made a big contribution of being people of deep faith. Their faith wanted to find deep understanding, and they turned to whatever resource they could find to make that interpretation. In the modern times, when Christian faith has been challenged by many people, secularists and those who think we've grown out of religion, there's a temptation on the part of some theologians to try to make our Christian message conform to the expectations of the fashions of thought of our own time. That's called liberal theology. It's pretty widespread among non-Catholic theologians, and even sometimes Catholic theologians are tempted to go down that path. John Henry Newman, the great English convert cardinal, was very aware of this danger and spoke very strongly against it. The faith is unchanging. The faith must not be compromised. And we must never be afraid of interpreting the faith and all its demands, all it affirms, the magnificent truths that it gives us, and not compromise those truths.